Welcome to the lesson on medians and right triangles. In this lesson, we will discuss and illustrate the special relationship that a median has in a right triangle. Now recall that a right triangle is a triangle with one right angle, and that a median is a segment coming from an angle of a triangle that bisects the opposite side. So to begin illustrating this, let's go ahead and draw, and informally draw, of course, a right angle triangle with one right angle. And let's draw a median coming from that right angle. So remember, a median comes from an angle, in this case the right angle, and bisects the opposite side. So as I label this ABC, point D is in the middle of A and B. Now, the big point that we're trying to prove is that CD, the median, is one half the hypotenuse. So CD is one half of AB. But let's go ahead and establish this with a proof and see that we can show that the median is indeed one half the hypotenuse every single time. So with this particular case, I know that DB starts off as being my median, and I'm trying to prove that it is half the hypotenuse. Now, because it's a median, AD is going to be congruent to DC. The hypotenuse is cut in half. And because DE is going to be parallel to AB, I know that it makes two right angles, and that DE, of course, is going to be congruent to itself. Now, because those lines are parallel, it's going to allow me to say that CE is also congruent to EB. And because of that, these two smaller triangles, CDE and DEB, are congruent because of side angle side, and that means DB is congruent to DC. And because DB is congruent to DC, which is half of its hypotenuse, DB, as a result, ends up being congruent to the entire hypotenuse. So I can say that DB is equal to one half of AC, that entire hypotenuse. Now, before we start working on some practice of this property, let's take a look at a very special median that goes into one of the special right triangles. In this case, we'll take a look at the 30-60-90, and we'll see what specifically its median does. So again, I constructed a median coming from the right angle, which divided my hypotenuse into two equal halves. I'll go ahead and label these four points in my right angle triangle. And again, I want to prove that BA is going to be equal to one half of BD. So I want to prove that one of my sides is also going to be equal to half the hypotenuse. Now I know the median is half the hypotenuse, so AC is equal to one half of BD. And I also know that AC is going to be equal to BC. Now, because of that, I create an isosceles triangle so that both these must be 60. And now the remaining must be 60, so I have an equilateral triangle with all three sides being equal. Now, that means that BA is equal to AC and BC. So if BA is equal, or congruent to rather, to AC, and I know that AC is one half of BD, I get that BA is exactly one half of BD. The side opposite the 30-degree angle is going to be exactly one half of the hypotenuse. So this must mean that that same side opposite the 30-degree angle must also be equal to the median. Now let's go ahead and put this property into practice. With this first problem, I notice that I have a 30-60-90 triangle and that the hypotenuse is 2. So BC, the side opposite the 30, has to be 1, and then my third side by the 30-60-90 degree property has to be root 3, and I could back that up with Pythagorean theorem. In the second one, I'm looking for AB and EB, where I know the median EC is 24. My median is half the hypotenuse. It means that this EB must be 24 and EA must be 24, so that my entire hypotenuse, AB, will end up being 48. In the third problem, I'm looking to find the perimeter of triangle CAF, so just one of the triangles of these parts. Now I notice that CF is a median, and it must also be 6.5 since it's going to be half of that hypotenuse there. And since that whole hypotenuse is 13 and one of the legs is 12, automatically the other leg is 5 because I recognize a Pythagorean triple. So by adding 5, 12, and 13, I get that my perimeter of this triangle ends up being 30.